Say we're given a linear programming problem in standard form, as denoted by P here with this problem data. Again, A is m by n with full row rank, B is an m vector and C is n vector. And suppose that we have a basis B determining a basic feasible solution for the system AX equal to B, X greater than or equal to 0. The tableau determined by B is this system here, obtained from the system Z minus C transpose X equal to 0, A sub B times X sub B plus A sub N times X sub N equal to B through elementary row operations. Now, let me just explain this notation a bit here in case you're not familiar with it. What this is just a shorthand for the following. The sum over all indices J in B, X sub J times A sub J. And for this second term here, the sum over all J in N, X sub J times A sub J. This should not be surprising because if you look at A times X can be written as the sum of J from 1 to N, XJ times AJ. So this expression on the left is basically splitting A times X into two, terms indexed by B and terms indexed by N. So this is the definition of the tableau. Now note that in the Z row, we don't want any basic variables to have non-zero coefficient. So as you can imagine, what we can do is, we first perform elementary row operations on these equations so that each basic variable appears in exactly one row. In using those, I eliminate all the basic variables from the Z row. So let's look at an example just to make this more clear. And suppose that my problem data are these. And we'll pick the basis B equal to 1, 3. And you can easily see that the basic feasible solution it determines is 0, 0, 2, 0. Let's try to write down the tableau determined by the basis B. And we'll start with writing down the Z row. In this case, I have minus x1 plus x2 minus 2x3 minus 3x4 equal to 0. And then the constraints. So that's the system that I'm starting with. Now I'm going to perform elementary row operations. I need to eliminate x1 from the second row. And to do that, let me call this row 1, row 2, and row 3. So row 3 is going to be replaced by row 3 minus 3 times row 2. And we'll end up with this. Okay, and then I'm going to replace row 2 by minus 1 half. Oh, okay, I'm going to replace row 3 by minus 1 half of row 3. And I'm going to do this in place. So minus 1 half is, this is going to be 2. And this is going to be 1, and this is going to be minus a half, and this is going to be 2. Now, I'm going to subtract row 3 from row 2, then this becomes minus x2, no more x3, and this is plus half x4, and this is 0. Okay, and now, I have exactly one basic variable in each equation, so I can eliminate the basic variables from the Z row. And I'm going to add the second row to the Z row and 2 times the third row to the Z row. And that will give me Z plus 4x2, and then minus 7 over 2x4 equal to 4. And then this is my tableau determined by the basis B. Now, let's focus on this tableau. So I'm going to erase everything that is not the tableau. And let me move the tableau over here. So, if I rewrite the Z row so that all the variables except Z are on the right, I will have 4 minus 4x2 plus 7 over 2x4. Now, notice that if I manage to find a feasible solution for p such that x2 is non-zero and x4 is 0, then I'll have a feasible solution with objective function value better than that of x star. Currently, the objective function value of x star is 4, right? Because if I plug in 0, 0, 2, 0 into x1, x2, x3, x4, I get z equal to 4. So if I have something positive for x2 but 0 for x4, then I will have a solution that is better than x star. And the question is, can we find the solution? So say keep x4 to 0 and set x2 equal to t, we get x1 equal to t, right? Because x2 is t and x4 is 0, and x3 equal to 2 minus 2t. But we want feasible solutions, so we need t to be at most 1 for x1 and x3 to be non-negative. Hence, we can set t equal to 1. And when t is equal to 1, we get x1 equal to 1 and x3 equal to 0. And x2 will be 1 as well. And when x2 is 1 and x1 is 1, my objective function value is 0. So new basic feasible solution is 1, 1, 0, 0. And the objective function value of this is 0. Now this solution is actually optimal because, well, first of all, the basis is 1, 2. And the dual solution that it determines, so if we compute y star equal to AB transpose inverse times CB, y star is going to be minus 1 half and 1 half. And this solution is feasible to dual and satisfies complementary slackness with this new basic feasible solution. So this is optimal. So this is an example that shows how you can find the improving direction and gets you to a new basic feasible solution, which in this case, it is optimal for the problem.